here today, good day, a day that we celebrate. It seems to me that in our history, maybe in life itself, it takes some very hard days to produce some good days. We look just at the very beginning of childbirth. It's a pretty hard day for the young ladies here present today. What comes out of that? Joy, life, a young child, and a new life in a new world. Think back how this day came about. The day came about to a lot of hard days and suffering, where brothers and uncles were fighting one another in our Civil War. Gettysburg alone, in the course of that great battle for freedom, the unification of our states into the union we have today, the United States of America, over 40,000 Americans died in 3 days over the course of July 1st, 2nd, and 3rd. So we're here today as a result of that great pain and suffering of our Civil War, because Congress passed a law, happen to do some of our life, maybe too many laws. They passed a good law way back when. It said we need a special day to honor our fallen Americans. And today that tradition continues. This is really hallowed ground that we stand on here today. You're privileged to have a cemetery near Bloomingburg. I guess we're in the town of Walkell, but we're privileged to have a cemetery here, close to our homes, that is a final resting place for two soldiers from that Civil War and every war thereafter. Last year, when I spoke in Wordsboro, I had the honor and privilege of speaking before my fellow veterans of foreign wars, including my dad, who was a veteran of World War II. He's gone now to that special place that's going to hold all of us. We are lucky here today to have Eddie Hanford from World War II here. And I remember over the years discussing with Eddie over a nice quiet cup of coffee in Wordsboro his part in what General Eisenhower called the Great Crusade. Great crusade to save Europe, freedom and democracy. So we here today remember, and we remember with memory, and we remember with great honor those who have passed on to that eternal army of freedom, those who have passed on from all wars here in the United States. I was in Desert Storm. 12 years later, my son Kurt joined George and 500,000 other young Americans in the Second Iraqi War. And today, we kind of lose sight of the thousands, the tens of thousands of families who are celebrating or honoring Memorial Day, knowing that their son and daughter is in Afghanistan. When we went overseas in Desert Storm, I remember my wife Kathy sending photos back showing the yellow ribbons. They were packed up on every telephone pole and tree in Wordsboro. There's also a big yellow ribbon on the maple tree in front of my house, because we kind of live back in the woods. And it was comforting to know that people in Wordsboro were thinking and remembering, I can't say the young boys, because I wasn't young when I went, but remembering those Americans who were serving in the First Iraqi War. Little did we appreciate that within 12 years, a new generation of American soldiers would be in Iraq. And then a few years later, another generation of American soldiers were in Afghanistan. we here in America enjoy freedom. But we know, certainly those of us who put on the uniform and gone in harm's way, we know that freedom is not free. It takes sacrifice, it takes pain, it takes the giving of a family, of their son or daughter, to go and put themselves in harm's way. And hopefully they return. Hopefully they return in one piece. It breaks my heart every Armistice Day, which we call November 11th, to see Sergeant Eddie Ryan from Ellenville.
Yes.
At the services over in Woodburn. See him in a wheelchair, shot in the head. So our freedom isn't free, and we can never take it for granted, because history has shown us, the great philosophers from Greece and Rome have told us, that a people who forget history are doomed to repeat it. Hopefully, the grace of God, we in America will not forget what history has taught us as a people. As a nation, that freedom, respect, honesty, and tolerance are key to what we hold so dear. I have had the privilege in the last several years to travel to many foreign countries, in Africa, republics of the former Soviet Union, in the Balkans. And every time I come back, I do appreciate the tolerance that we have, because so many wars, so much suffering is caused by man's intolerance to another. We don't like their religion, we don't like their color, we don't like their ethnicity. Good. We'll go out and kill them or burn their village down. That's the history of the world. We in America know and appreciate difference. The difference being freedom, tolerance, and respect for all people. And that's what makes America so great. It was once told to me, and I appreciate the analogy more and more, that we in America are like a salad. We have our tomatoes, we call them Italians. We have our turnips, we call them Russians. We have our rice, beans, we call them Mexicans. We can go on and on. But when you combine all those lovely ingredients into one bowl that we call the United States of America, what do we have? We have a strong, vibrant, tough people, because we mix the radishes with the radishes, the lettuce, the carrots. If we just had a bowl of carrots to eat, we wouldn't have that diversity that has always, always from the beginning, made America what it is today. We forget what the forefathers went through. Mine weren't here. They were over in Europe. But those folks that migrated to America back in the 1600s and 1700s, they came here for religious freedom, economic freedom, and social freedom. Because they no longer wanted to live in a country as beautiful as Ireland because of the caste system. They had to leave places like Russia and other places because of the intolerance to certain people living in their countries. So on this beautiful day, we reflect. Reflect on the memories, the memorials made to those who put on a uniform and put themselves in harm's way to protect, preserve, safeguard forever the freedoms that we all love and enjoy. Thank you so much.